Welcome to the first section of our course, Understanding Your Customer's Journey. My name is Jeannie Walters, and in this section, I will be giving you an introduction to customer experience. I'd like to start with a story. My son wanted a nice computer. He had done a lot of research and knew exactly what components were most important to him. He likes to create animated videos and play video games, both of which require serious power. He showed us some options, and the prices were just too high. So he got creative. He researched how to build his own machine and set to work finding the best individual components to include. It was impressive to watch him figure out exactly what graphics card and power supply he needed. We agreed this was a much better option. The price was right, and he was learning a valuable skill for the future. So computer parts started arriving at the house in box after box. He put everything together, but the one part that took the longest to arrive was the graphics card. It was in high demand, and he was willing to wait for the delayed arrival. But you can imagine the excitement when this last, most important part arrived. He added the coveted part to the system, and it didn't work. After tinkering and testing the graphics card in another machine, he realized that his brand new piece was a dud. It simply didn't work. So our son contacted the company where he purchased it and went through the process of testing and retesting with them to show how it didn't work. They agreed to accept the return, and he sent it off with their shipping label. A few weeks later, he hadn't heard anything. After not hearing anything from the company, he used the online chat to contact customer service. The representative had to look up his order and track his return. "Oh," she clarified, "they had received it, but it takes 8 days to process." So he waited 8 days and contacted them again. They explained it'll take a few more days to process, and then they'll send his replacement. Now, keep in mind, no money was refunded. The company had the money and the item. He had contacted them on the phone and chat and email. Each time, they explain why it's a busy time or why schedules are delayed. But they never contacted him proactively. If he weren't actively following up, I wonder what would happen. As of today, he's still waiting. I can see a day in the future when the computer he built will bring him a lot of pride and be very useful. But when he talks about building it, what story do you think he'll mention? This is just one example of a customer journey gone wrong. There was nothing wrong with the sales process. Most of the time, the product works fine, but they made it so cumbersome when their product didn't work. And this company has to respond to additional chat requests and service calls. Do you think my son will recommend this retailer to other tech-focused friends? Of course not. And so this company not only loses sales, they lose referrals, happy customers, and positive word-of-mouth marketing, simply because they aren't focused on the end-to-end experience for their customers. Customer experience is not about one interaction or expectation. The customer's journey is not just about sales or service. It's about every interaction throughout the customer journey. And it's about how customers feel during that journey. Customer experience is the total relationship your customer has with your organization through communication, interactions, and transactions. And now there are so many ways to interact. Customers want to interact on their terms. Each unique interaction, whether it's in person, on social media, via text message, or chat, or whatever communication channel comes next, is referred to as a touch point. Touch points can be neutral, meeting the expectations of the customer exactly, or they can promote loyalty by exceeding those expectations. Of course, those touch points can build trust and loyalty, or erode that trust and create negative customer experiences. And things don't always go right. That's why understanding your customer's journey and how you can create more positive customer experiences rather than negative ones is so important to your business outcomes. So can you guess where it all starts? Reviewing the journey from your customer's perspective. That means flipping the script from focusing inside your business and taking an outside-in approach. This goes way beyond your organizational chart or any internal process maps you may have. Your customers experience their journey their way. So it's important to understand that viewpoint. And at the heart of that viewpoint is how they feel about their interactions with you. When you connect the dots of the business results you want, customer loyalty, retention, positive word of mouth referrals, with the customer experience you want to provide, effortless, positive, and exceeding expectations, then you have a powerful formula for success. What if you don't deliver for customers? What if you don't make the effort to understand their journey? Well, you can be sure that your competitor will make that effort. Ready to understand your customers more? Let's go on a journey. To invest in your customers, it's important to define what that investment will bring your business. That's what we'll cover next.